Dear students, how are you? I am fine. Today we will read about writing paragraph. That means how to write a paragraph. In a paragraph, there are some question given, and you have to answer the question. And in this way, you write the paragraph. Look, when writing the paragraph, you must consider about four things. Four things. Number one is title. Number two, opening or introductory sentence. Number three, developing. And number four, conclusion. There is an example of paragraph is given. The topics is about traffic jam. So in the question paper, the topic is given and topic will be given and some question will be given there. You have to answer the questions, and in this way you have to write the full paragraph. Now the number one, title. At the very first moment you have to write the title of the paragraph, and the title is given and the topic is given in the question. Here is the title is traffic jam, so you have to write the title traffic jam. And after, in the title there is no full stop given. You must not give the full stop. You just only write the words. Then when you start writing, after the title and when you start writing, there will be some distance, not a very few distance, some distance. And it a paragraph may you may write in one para or maybe two para, but one para writing, you can write whatever you wish. So then you write the opening or introductory sentence. And look, there is the question, and if there is the question is not such a type that you write with this questions the introductory sentence, then you can add the introductory sentence. Suppose there is given what is traffic jam. What do you mean by traffic jam? In this case, you can write the introductory sentence by answering these questions, and the answer may be, traffic jam means blockade of vehicles on roads and streets. It is an unmoving state of vehicles on road. You can write in this way. Here, in this way, you answer the questions, and again, you also write the introductory sentence. Then, developing. That means the questions answers, clues answers. The next clue is, what are the causes of traffic jam? Here, the answer may be two or three sentences, but you just know, consider that you must write one sentence, at least one sentence. And if it is necessary, then you can write two or three sentences also for each question. So what are the causes of traffic jam? So what I write first, at first, traffic jam means blockade of vehicles on roads and streets. It is an unmoving state of vehicles on road. Okay, then the B number question answer. It is, you know, what are the causes of traffic jam? It mainly, okay, then you can add another line. It mainly occurs at the crossing point of the road. It is a great problem in urban areas. There are a number of reasons of traffic jam. What contributes a lot to the traffic jam is overpopulation. Unlicensed and unauthorized rickshaws are the main causes of traffic jam. Violating traffic rules and regulations, illegal parking of vehicles on roads also causes traffic jam. Again, narrow roads and frequent digging for development work also are cause of traffic jam. Building materials are piled up on roads cause traffic jam too. Whatever the causes of traffic jam may be, I think it is an unbearable problem for the urban people. Like this way, you can answer the B number questions. Then number C, what is the effect of traffic jam? That means what are the results of traffic jam? So as I write in the question number B, that in the last line is, whatever the causes of traffic jam may be, I think it is an unbearable problem for the urban people. So I can add from there. In our daily activities, we cannot become fast and punctual because traffic jam kills our valuable time. Office going people, school going children and dying patients fall victim to traffic jam. As people cannot attend their work timely, it leaves a negative impact on our economy. So it is the bounden responsibility of the authority concerned to solve this problem. But it is very difficult to solve this problem. Look, you can add some lines here which is not directly asked in your question, but you to write the paragraph, you can add this line also because it consists the cohesiveness of the writing. That's why. Then number four, when does generally a traffic jam occur? Generally a traffic jam occurs at a office time or school time and after returning from the office time and school time. Then how can traffic jam be removed? Then it is what are the remedies? Here the remedies you must write. So it requires united effort to solve this problem. In some places government should build flyover. Drivers should be trained and made aware of the traffic rules and regulations. Illegal parking on roads should be banned. Narrow roads should be made spacious. Rickshaws should be removed from main roads. Finally, the traffic rules should be implemented strictly. Besides, we should not cross the roads in an indisciplined way. So these are the removal of traffic jam. Now there is no questions, but you have to write one conclusion line, the ending line. So you can, whatever you wish, you can write it related to your topics. So here I can write, all these measures may be a solution to the traffic jam. So in this way you can write a paragraph, any topics in the question paragraph. In the question the topic is given about the things related to our daily life or recent incidents. So you can write by this way, by answering the questions and giving what is number one, the title, then the introductory sentence, then answering the questions cohesively, and then the conclusion or ending line. So I think you can understand it well. Thank you very much.